Shadow study is an essential part when assessing the potential of new development. In some cases, the shadows from the proposed building would fall on public spaces, such as parks and sidewalks. In this short tutorial, I will demonstrate how to assess the impact of shadows, including area calculation and exporting images and GIFs animations using Shadow Colour for Revit. To learn more, visit our website linked in the description below. In my Revit view, I have a context model, which is a Link3D CAD, a massing for the approved development, and my proposed building. I also have a scale bar down here, which is a detail family. I will ensure the view is cropped and shadows are on. Let's go to the Add-ins tab and open Shadow Colour. The next step is to quickly select elements from the view and assign colors. So I have all my elements, now let's select colors. The city context will have a dark gray. Let's pick an orange for my proposed building and blue for the approved development. Before clicking on preview image, I want to change the order of the elements. Let's move the approved to be on top of my proposed building. I'll click on preview image and see what we got so far. I got the shadows with the assigned colors. As you can see, at certain hours, my proposed building casts shadows covering the park. Now I want to see the additional shadows on the park, give it a different color and calculate the shadows area. I will create a new site using the property line. Under properties, I'll give my site a name. I will call it Park. On Shadow Colour, I'll select Add Site and pick the property line from the view. Under my site, I will pick color for the shadows within the site. Let's pick dark blue for the approved building and red for my proposed building. After selecting colors, I can always save the style to use later or load the style. I also have the option to delete layer. Before clicking on preview, I will turn on the area calculator. When the area calculator is on, the preview will be include an area calculation report. In the drop-down menu, I can choose the accuracy. Quick will generate a quick preview of the areas, while Max will create a more accurate result, but will take longer to produce. I will keep it quick. Next to the preview image, I can see the area calculations. I have the overall site area, the approved building, which is in dark blue, and it covers about 15.5% of the park. And my proposed building covers 29% of the park, which is about 1,238 square meters. The next step is to export the shadow study images. I'll go to File, Export. I can export a single image with the current view settings, or I can export multiple frames using the interval option. Here I can choose the date, the hours, the time interval. Let's keep it 1 hour. The image quality. I can export a superposition image, GIF animation, and the area calculation datasheet. I'll click export. I've got all the images exported. I have the GIF animation. A superposition image with overlaid shadows. And an Excel sheet for the area calculation. Here we can see the time and the hour of each day and the area of the shadow cast on the park. Thanks for watching and see you next time.